have to be human?
Beep, beep.
Does it have to be mine?
Beep, beep.
Where am I supposed to get it?
Beep me, Seymour. Beep me all night long. That's right, boy. You can do it. Beep me, Seymour. Beep me all night long. Cause if you feed me same old, I can grow up big and strong.
You eat blood, Audrey, too. Let's face it, how am I supposed to keep on feeding you? Kill people?
I'll make it worth your while.
Look, you're a plant, an inanimate object.
Does this look inanimate to you, punk? If I can talk and I can move, who's to say I can't do anything I want?
Good evening. My name is Randal Metz, and I'm with the Puppet Company, and this is my partner, Dennis Lancaster of Intermission Productions, and together we have created the Audrey II plant, ta-da, that we're about to show you how to make and work and deal with. So, what we're going to do is we're going to take you through all the steps of doing each plant individually. Dennis has been kind enough to get inside each of the costumes, puppets for us, and I will explain all of the different workings of the figures as we go along. And first of all, we'd like to start with plant number one. Each of the plants you're about to see are very unique. They're made out of craft velour and foam, so they're very light and easy to use. They have a real life texture, and because they move so easily, it gives them a great sense of character on stage. This is plant number one. This is the one that grows in the opening scene. It's very easy to work. It's worked by putting your hand inside the plant and holding your hand in a position like this. By lowering your thumb up and down, you'll get the plant to talk or open its mouth. Inside the plant's head, located right about here, you'll find a stitch. If you take that stitch, which is going down vertically from top to bottom of the jaw, you can take your fingers and put them on either side of the stitch like this. Now, the reason we ask you to do this is because when you're working the plant, if you're working the lower jaw, you can then grab that stitch between your fingers and pull back like this, and it gives the plant a great grimace, which I shall now demonstrate. I'm going to put the plant onto my hand. The one thing to remember about plant number one is it's sort of like a vampire. You know you're wearing it correctly if the two fangs in the top jaw are pointed towards you. If you have it on your hand where your thumb is located in this jaw here with the two fangs pointing up, you've got it on wrong. You want to make sure that your four fingers are inside the top jaw with the two pointed down fangs. Now, just to give you an idea, I lower my thumb and I get the plant to talk. Hey, Dennis, what's up, dude? Now, if I take it and I grab that stitch between my fingers, I can then pull back and give it a great grimace, just like this. This is very effective at the end of the scene. If you can pull back on that one stitch and just have that lower jaw going back and forth like this. Okay, we're now going to show you how to preset plant number one. If you hold it up like this, you will notice that there's a pot here, there's a cord going down to the bottom. This string is very important for your puppeteer, and I'll explain that in just a moment. Also, on the side of the pot here, you will notice there are four strings running from these giant leaves all the way to this ring over here. This is the ring that makes the plant wilt when Seymour is sent to take care of it. Now, in presetting your plant, you want to do it this way. Hold the plant, put your hand inside the plant until it's very comfortably on your hand, just like this. Make sure that this ring is located to the back here, facing you. This means that you now have the plant exactly as it should be held. Okay, close the jaw and pull the plant all the way down tight into the pot, just like this. Okay, once you have it tight into the pot, take your arm and very carefully pull it out, making a hole with your hand. Now push all the fabric away from the hole you just made. You need to have this opening when you're working the plant at the end of the scene. Otherwise, you're going to put your hand into the plant and your fingers are going to hit a whole bunch of fabric and you won't have a clear shot all the way to the head. Now Dennis is going to take the plant here and he's going to put the leaves up around it, making sure that the Velcro sections here, you notice there are different colored Velcro sections, match the different areas of the plant where they're supposed to be. Here, for example, is the orange one. You got the others, Dennis? There we go. And it Velcros all the way around. Now, for the sake of this documentary, Dennis is going to be Seymour, okay? Now, as Seymour, Dennis has taken his thumb and inserted it into the metal ring, which is located on the side. Now, he's going to turn towards the audience so they don't see the ring, and Seymour and Mushnick deliver their lines. When it's time for the plant to wilt, he very carefully takes his thumb and pulls it down, which causes all four leaves to wilt on the plant. Then he'll take that ring and he'll pull it down and you hook it onto the curtain hook, which is located at the base of the plant. Once the plant is in Seymour's hands, he's going to put it on the table with a hole cut into it. And one of the ways you can mask having the puppeteer put his hands in here, because you don't want this to move, Seymour could actually be touching it and petting it and all that. And in actuality, he's holding the plant rigid down so the puppeteer can slide his hand up into this. It kind of shows a bond between him and Seymour, and it also covers the fact the puppeteer is struggling to get his hand into this. All right, once again, Dennis, as Seymour, is going to bring the plant over to the floral table, which he's already told you has had a hole cut into the top. Now the hole should match the circumference of this pot. What's going to happen is your puppeteer is underneath the table like this, scrunched down low, so that he can receive, first of all, this black string. Once the puppeteer has the black string, he will grab a hold of it and pull it down. This will anchor the pot sturdy into the hole that you've cut. Now, Seymour, still holding onto the plant, helps the puppeteer reach his hand up into that prearranged hole. Now that I have my hand successfully put into the plant, I'm holding onto the cord and holding onto the plant itself. Seymour singing his song, and of course he's dropping blood into the plant. The puppeteer just has to very lightly open up the mouth slightly like this. One thing I like to do is every once in a while do a jerk like it's trying to jump out of the pot and grab some blood. That's always quite effective. Anyway, Seymour finishes his song and exits the stage. Now at this point, we suggest that you take the last few notes of the song and elongate them. Give your puppeteer a chance to really make the plant come to life. And how he does that is by holding on to the string, which holds it into the platform. He's very carefully going to thrust his arm up, at the same time moving from side to side as though the plant's trying to break its way out of its growth area. It raises all the way up as far as the puppeteer can reach his arm into the pot, looks around, shows its teeth, goes from side to side, nods its head, aha, I have a sucker, then very carefully pulls back into its grimace and does its ha 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 ha, all on the end of the music, and then on the very last note he just goes boomp back into the pot and you have a blackout. And that's how you work Audrey plant number one. This is the second of the Audrey II plants. This is the puppet that Seymour will perform on stage. And it's worked like this. Dennis has taken his arm and put it through a hole that's in the back of the actual flower pot. You can see it right over here. He's reached up inside through the green neck and up into the plant itself. Now his hand inside the plant looks something like this. He's got a thumb in the lower jaw. He's got his third finger stuck inside the tongue. If he puts his third finger in the tongue, he can get the tongue to actually work. His other three fingers are actually on the top jaw of the puppet. So it looks something like this. And again, the puppeteer is just moving his hand in Muppet style to make the puppet work. Now this is a very interesting plant because it comes with a fake arm. This is its arm right here. Now, when you have your show in operation, Seymour obviously has his own jacket. So we're going to let you use your own jacket for this particular number. What's going to happen is you stick this arm inside the sleeve of the jacket. Seymour puts the jacket on with the help backstage, and what's happening is his actual arm is going out the front of his jacket and into the pot of the plant itself, while the fake arm is going into the sleeve of the jacket and up onto his shoulder. The other arm of his jacket is actually going onto his other arm. Now, once he has that, the costumer is going to zip up his jacket so it hides as much of his fake arm, his real arm, I should say, as possible. Now, to help with this illusion, we are supplying two gloves for the plant operator to use. Now, you can either use these gloves, or you can take this fake hand and wrap it in bandages and add a little blood so it looks like Seymour's hand is all bandaged up from having fed the plant too much. We suggest the best thing to do is use the gloves. What you do is you attach the glove to the hand and sew it to the pot with the two holes that are supplied in the side of the pot. This other glove actually goes onto Seymour's real hand. Now Seymour looks like he's wearing two gloves. One of them obviously fake and stuffed, the other one his real hand. Now this is important because this is a big dance number for the plant. While Seymour is using the one hand to gesticulate, he uses the other hand to move the puppet from side to side. How you actually choreograph the number is up to you, but we always like to see Audrey moving as much as possible when people are not looking at her. One wonderful thing that this puppet can do is it can open its mouth really, really wide and go towards one of the bebop girls, and as it reaches towards her, it can move the tongue like it's going to get her. And of course, then if they turn around, the plant will go back to normal and hide back inside the pot. And this is basically how you work Audrey 2, number 2. Dennis, did you want to add anything? Welcome to Audrey 2, plant number 3. This is what we call the showstopper. This is the plant that sings Feed Me, and it really is quite an effective figure. What you see here on the ground is what we call the plant base, or a low flower pot. It's set up so that it has a swivel chair up here on the top part of the base. This is where the puppeteer is going to sit. All around it is located some lawn edging to make it look like a pot. On the inside of it is some shag green fur, and then we've just added some green rope going out the side so it looks like, you know, sort of roots. If you look at it from underneath, you will see that it has four wheels. Oh, five. We've added one. It has five wheels located on the base itself. This allows it to move around the platform so that if you wanted to, you could actually wheel your Audrey 3 plant in and wheel it off stage. Now, I take a moment at this point to talk about the way the show is set up. The way that Little Shop of Horrors has been set up has been that it has given the puppeteer time to be in and out of the Audrey 2 costumes. If you put your puppeteer into the costumes for too long a time and you set them on stage under the hot lights, this is not good for your puppeteer. So they have designed certain scenes, and those are the ones that take place outside on the street. And I think if you look at the script, it says a scrim is pulled all the way across the stage, and it exposes the street scene where the doo-wop girls and Seymour and Mushnick and all the other characters usually have their small little scenes before entering the floral shop. Now, this is good because during those times, the puppeteer is actually being removed from the costume or being set up on stage in the costume. The choice is yours on how you want to exactly do this. If you are one of the theaters that do not have the luxury of having the scrim that goes across, you're going to have to allow for stagehands to wheel your Audrey 2 plant performer on stage and off stage. If you leave your performer into this costume for the entire whole rest of Act 1, this is not advisable. And if you look at the notes on tips on how to perform Audrey 2, you will see that we suggest that they are removed from the stage while the dentist is doing his scene and song, and there are a couple of other places where we suggest that the puppeteer is let out. Your puppeteer should have on his back a Camelback water bottle. That's one of those strap-on water bottles that have a little tiny suck hose that goes up the front and is inside his mouth. This way, while he's performing the Audrey II plant, he can have water going in and out. This is a good thing for him to have also. Now, about Audrey II number 3. The way the puppeteer is going to work this plant is he's sitting on this platform with his legs crossed, such as this. The mouth is sort of like a giant Muppet puppet. The top arm is going up inside of the head, while the bottom arm is going into the lower jaw. And until he starts to sing, we suggest that the puppeteer just sits himself like this and waits for his scene. When he bends over and he wilts the first time, he just kind of goes boom, boom, boom. And he goes, "Feed me." And he moves his hands like this. And Seymour says, "What?" And he says, "Feed me." And he raises his hands apart a little bit more. Until finally, he's working the puppet full out like this. Now, Dennis is going to show you this in operation in just a second. One of the other things that the Audrey II plant can do is it has a tongue that can actually be moved inside the figure. What's going to happen is the puppeteer will pull his arm out of the lower jaw and stick it into the sleeve of the tongue. When he does this, all of a sudden the tongue can move back and forth. It can lick its lips all around, and it can also grab things by going like this and pulling them into an open hole that's inside the costume.
As Randall was telling you, I'm going to show you how to manipulate the plants inside. And another additional postscript: when you're in the plant and you're making the upper jaw and the lower jaw move, when you do those initial feed me's, turn your hand this direction and push down very slightly. That'll cause the lower lip just to move very, very small. That way, when you do your large feed me Seymour, it'll really be jolting to the audience.
Go ahead.
Now, this is the latest in fashion footwear for you plant people. The way to tell of how to put these on is look for the large leaf on the outside of the legs. And you slip these good guys in here, and you're good to go to get on the base. And you may need to have your assistant help you sit down on it, and I know I'm going to need one. Now we're ready to get into the plant, and I want to provide some information to the lighting director. It is not necessary to fully light this plant. In fact, we recommend that you use fill lights to light this or shoot through a gobo. That does a couple of things. One, it lets all this wonderful paintwork here act as makeup. Treat this paintwork as makeup. If you light it too much, you're going to wash it all out. And the other thing is to save the poor actor inside. You don't want to cook him up, and I'm sure Randall can attest to this. Having too many lights in there, you're going to cook your actor up. He's just going to boil inside, and it's not really necessary. So whenever you have the plant move or when you light the plant, just use a little fill lighting on the side. And again, use a gobo. And that gives the plant quite a bit of mystery. And we sling this over to Randall here.
As Dennis said, there's a certain mystery to not being able to see everything. Now, let's talk about the plant here. This is one giant costume. You can see that it's one head attached with a green bodysuit down there. And the bodysuit is actually just a flap. You can see right here, this is all the front part of the plant, and it goes over the actor's crotch. And this is the actual part that goes over the actor's head. Now, if you look inside the plant, you'll see that the actor can see outside of it. All he has to do is kind of push down and he can see Seymour, so he can follow Seymour from side to side. Also, we might add that this right here is the tongue that we were talking about. If you put your arm all the way into the tongue, you can get the tongue to do all sorts of things like this. Yeah, thanks. Okay. That's the tongue. Now, I'm going to put this on to Dennis. Are you ready?
Yes. You may want your actor to be wearing either a black or a red t-shirt. That way, when he does open his mouth, this white t-shirt doesn't show through and spoil the effect.
That's very important.
I'm helping.
You're helping. Also, inside of the plant is a pouch. And the pouch is located right about here on the side of the mouth. This is a water bottle with a fan. We suggest you find one if there isn't one in the box already supplied. Now, you can purchase these water bottles at any Walmart or any drugstore. It's important to keep them filled at all times. Now, what your puppeteer or your puppeteer's assistant is going to do is to place this water bottle, and it's going to be located somewhere up here in the top of the mouth. There's a pocket on the inside. You're going to stick the whole thing into the pocket, and you're going to turn the fan so that it's facing up a little at the puppeteer. You want to make sure that when you spin the fan, it doesn't catch on the actual plant itself and stop working. Now, during the performance, the puppeteer can turn on the fan if he wishes. He doesn't need to, but it's a nice little addition. He can also squirt his face with the water bottle by moving his hand out of the lower jaw, reaching up and squirting himself. Now, one thing to remember, the fan is operated by battery power. We found this out in a very interesting way when I was inside the plant one time. The person who was helping me had changed the batteries on me without actually telling me they had done this. What they had done was they had put the batteries in backwards. This made the actual fan work, but it made the fan work in reverse. If you don't have your batteries in correctly, these fans will suck the air out of your costume rather than supplying air into your costume. So always be sure when you change the batteries on these fans that you do it the correct way that is shown. Now, also remember the puppeteer has his camel back on so he can get fresh water if he needs to during the scene. And another nice little thing we suggest is to get one of those scarves that you wet in water and then freeze in the freezer just prior to performance. If you wrap that around your puppeteer's neck just prior to getting into this costume, it'll help regulate his blood temperature, which is always nice to cool them off.
Cool the blood, you cool the body.
Cool the blood, cool the body. It'll make these much more exciting to wear. All right, now, are you ready, Dennis? Before I put this on to Dennis, I'd like to suggest one more thing, which Dennis reminded me of during production one time. It's always nice to have your puppeteer perform these costumes, plants 3 and plants 4, without having them on a couple of times. Just put them onto the set, set them into the base, set them onto the stool for plant number 4, but let them see where your Seymour, your Audrey, your Mushnick, and your dentist are going to be at all times. This allows the puppeteer to make a mental note of where he has to turn at any given point in the show. It makes the performance much more believable, and it helps your puppeteer be able to see when it might be difficult for him to see inside the costume at any given time. Now, let's put this on. Each puppeteer should have a costume dresser. The costume dresser holds the plant up until the puppeteer puts his arms like this into the top and bottom of the jaw. Dennis, have you got them in there?
Yep.
Okay, good. Now, the next thing the puppeteer costumer is going to do is to look for all of this wonderful root stuff that's in the front and put it into the crotch area and all around Dennis like this. You can see that I'm using the leaves to act as decoration. He also makes sure, or she makes sure, that the legs for the puppeteer are crossed and inside the base. Okay, now, most of the time, you'll see the plant just like this, mouth closed. Your actors are able to move all the way around him. One neat thing about this Audrey II plant is that if he keeps his mouth closed and he doesn't show off his teeth too much, it can be very effective. In one performance, we saw where the costumer had covered over the teeth, much like this, so you didn't see them inside. And then the dentist, when he was doing his soliloquy about how wonderful the plant was, walked up and picked up the gum and pulled them open like this and said, "Ooh, nice teeth." This sent a shiver through the audience because nobody had actually seen there were actually big teeth inside that head. Now, I'm going to let Dennis kind of work the plant for you and give you an idea of what's going to happen. I'll be Seymour. First thing that happens is the plant falls onto its face as if it needs water. And Seymour runs up to it, and the plant very carefully says, "Feed me." See how he did that? Just very gently by putting his hand in the bottom of the jaw and lowering it. "Feed me." Seymour said, What are you talking about? And he said again, very gently, "Feed me." And then finally on the third one, he says, "But you're a plant, how can I do that?" And the plant jumped up and said, feed me now. And he opened up his full mouth to show the audience. He was pretty terrifying. This is very effective. Now, we call that maneuver where we turn the palm upside down, we call that the Elvis drawl. See how he's lowering just the bottom lower jaw there. Kind of gives it that "feed me, Seymour," without actually having that kind of annoying open mouth going all the time and flapping. The more subtle you are with these creatures, the more powerful their performance will be. Now, as you can see, he's got complete movability. I can walk on either side and he listens for my voice and he can see me go from side to side. And if he needs to, he can very carefully lift up his head and look through that hole. And he'll be able to see me by looking through the hole too. Now, Dennis, would you like to show the tongue for them? Dennis has now brought the tongue out, and he's making it work. You can see he's no longer using the bottom jaw. He's using his other arm to do a complete tongue motion. This is great. Usually the tongue is moving when Seymour is singing the song where he goes, I don't know, and the tongue is just moving all around the body. And then after that one little verse, the arm goes back inside the lower jaw, and the plant is ready to sing again, full mouth. Good. Now, I'm going to show you how to feed plant number 3. The plant is wheeled down at the end of Act 1, and it's licking its lips, and it's moving all around. It sees Seymour, so it looks up at him. He very carefully takes out a body part, or in this case, Dennis's shoe. And what he's going to do is he's going to reach in and make sure, now hold on a minute, grab the shoe please. He's going to make sure that the puppeteer has grabbed the complete shoe. Once he feels that the puppeteer has grabbed it, he lets it go. The puppeteer then moves it all around and sticks it all the way back into the hole where he is hiding himself. So you can see it's sort of like the Cookie Monster eating cookies. He's throwing it down into the costume. Once he has it all the way down, he reaches out for something else. So we may give him a fan this time. There he goes. He's got the fan, and he'll do the same thing.
This isn't a balanced diet. I mean, this is...
Right. It's not a very balanced diet. Another neat thing that can happen is when Seymour is feeding the plant, he can reach too close, the plant can grab him, and we can do a tug-of-war thing where Seymour pulls free to get away from it. And the plant kind of just teases him back and forth. Finally, the plant eats everything there is to be eaten, and he ends Act 1. During the course of the song, the plant has a point where he says, "Does this look inanimate to you?" What he's referring to are his feet. What he does is he kicks one foot out, and then he kicks the other foot out, and he wiggles them back and forth as he's teasing Seymour that he's able to actually dance. So if you have a puppeteer who's very agile, you can see how the plant is crawling all the way around the stage by rotating on the swivel chair. Or even better, he can do kicks to keep in time with the music, and he can actually do some dancing with Seymour if you so desire. As in using any sets of Audrey II plants, when the puppeteer has finished the scene, get him backstage, remove him from the plant, and give him room to breathe. It's always good to have a bottle of water chilled nearby, just in case he so desires, or a drink of some kind. Thank you, Dennis.
You're welcome.
And now, please the resistance of the entire Audrey II set of plants. Plant number 4. This is the biggest, of course, of all the plants, and actually probably the easiest of all of them to work. It consists of several different elements. This is all one giant costume. It has an upper jaw, and it has a lower jaw. Located in the lower jaw, you will find on either side of the tongue these red straps. What they do is they allow the puppeteer to be able to move the mouth without using the PVC pipes, which are located at the back, which I will talk about in just a second. The puppeteer looks through this opening right here, which are covered up by these tonsils, so you really don't see him that well. He wears the plant by putting the whole costume over his body, and so that if I was wearing the plant right now, I would be entirely in the top half of the plant, not the bottom jaw. The bottom jaw would be located on the floor. What I would do is there's a shoulder brace, which is inside the plant, which rests on my shoulders. I reach my arm through that opening, which he looks out of, and while reaching out my arm, I'm wearing this red glove, which I will give to Dennis right here. This also acts as tonsils for the plant, but more importantly, it allows you to reach those two red handles and pull the whole jaw up to you, so that when you're working the plant, you're actually holding your arm in close like this, and every time he talks, you're thrusting your arm out in this way. And you're bending your body. The more you bend your body from side to side, the more maneuverability the whole plant's going to have. And Dennis will be happy to demonstrate that in just a moment. But also thrusting your arm out to get it to talk. So when it laughs, your whole body looks something like this. And you're using your entire body to make it work. Also with this plant, you have this lovely stool, which we're not going to send you if you are shipped these plants because it weighs just a little bit too much for shipping. But this is just a common 2 to 3 foot stool, and all you have to do is find something like this so that your puppeteer can sit on it during the first part of Act 2. You are now looking at the back end of the Audrey II plant number 4. If you look inside, you'll see there's a hole in the middle of the plant. That's where the head of the puppeteer goes. All around him is a foam collar which rests on his shoulders. Over here you have jutting out on both sides of the mouth PVC pipe. And if you notice, they go all the way through to holes which are just inside of the plant itself. These holes, which are located underneath the red fur, are where the puppeteer are going to grab the jaw to make the plant laugh. So when we say, grab the PVC pipe and lift the jaw up, they're going to reach along the sides of the mouth towards those PVC pipes which are in that hole. These back ones are just to act as guidance if they need to feel something, and then they can move down and find the actual hole itself. And that's the back end of the plant. You will notice that if you're looking for those holes, they are located at the bottom of the gum line. So just feel along the sides and you'll find the two holes in order to grab them to make the jaw work without using the red straps. Now, we're going to put Dennis inside this costume. Your Audrey plant is laid out like this on the floor prior to inserting the puppeteer into it. What you would like to do is make sure your puppeteer has on his red glove, so that he can do the tonsils and any sort of device around his neck to cool himself off, or water or whatever he needs. Then we're going to lift up the plant, and he's going to very carefully put it over his head. Dennis, are you inside the plant?
I am inside the plant.
All right. Now, he's standing up inside the plant now, and if you notice, you will look through this hole right here and you can see where his hand is extending. He is now perfectly situated into the plant. Good, thank you. Now, in order to make sure the plant's going to work properly, once he's inside this plant, your puppeteer costumer, plant costumer, is going to want to make sure that all of this velour here, which is actually hiding the puppeteer's legs from being seen, is all very carefully tucked into the mouth. This is where Mushnik and everybody else is going to be eaten through. Now, take the brown fur and very carefully lay out all of the leaves all around the plant. This makes it look like the plant is taking root and is taking over the shop.
I can probably lift the lower jaw too.
Okay.
Go ahead and set it up in there.
Once your puppeteer is inside and ready to go, he'll tell you, give me the jaw. Very carefully fold the tongue, grab those two straps, and lift up until the puppeteer can grab it. This is how the plant should look at the beginning of Act Two. When the plant is ready to start moving, it gently lowers forward by moving your body forward. Now, if the puppeteer pushes his arm out, he's able to make the plant talk. You can see that he's just making that jaw move by pushing his arm in and out. The other thing Dennis is doing is he's moving from side to side to have his body in complete movement. You may notice every once in a while he jerks and he moves the thing, so it looks like he's doing syllables. This is all up to your puppeteer to decide how well he wants to make this believable. But the more you shake the mouth, the more syllables you can get. You can see that he's making the lower jaw very gently thrust out like we did with plant number three. Now, the reason we have used this type of performance technique for making him talk is because there's a lot of air that needs to be displaced inside of this figure. The lower jaw is very massive, and when we used just the PVC pipes, which were at the back, and just by lifting up the PVC pipes, we couldn't get enough strength to get that entire lower jaw to move up fast. So what we did was we added these straps so that the puppeteer has better lip syncing capabilities for the puppet. We suggest that you use this technique the entire time it's being operated, unless it's eaten somebody. When someone is eaten, then the puppeteer can reach behind, he'll lower the jaw, reach behind. Now Dennis is grabbing those PVC pipes. Now, that's the movement you'll get from the PVC pipes. You can see that it's not as controlled, but it is a nice little laugh, so it can go. Now, Dennis, move the two rods close together. You see how the mouth is making a U? He's doing that by taking the two rods and pushing them together against his body. Dennis is doing several things here. He's awesome. Forming a U, and the other thing he's doing is he's taking his knee and he's bouncing it off the bottom jaw. And he's doing a and again, he's using his whole body to get the puppet to move. This is very effective. We suggest you use the PVC pipes only after he's eaten somebody and at the very end of the show when you want the puppet to move forward into the audience. And there he is, he's moving. Dennis, you want to move forward a little? You can see by pushing his legs forward, the plant can walk into the audience. There we go. Now that we've shown you how to move the actual plant, we're going to talk about the puppeteer comfort in the very beginning of Act Two. This stool here, after the puppeteer has been inserted into the costume, the plant costumer helper is going to give the puppeteer the stool, and he's going to sit on it, and you cover it over from the back, go behind, make sure he's all smoothed out, and then once again, hand the lower jaw to the puppeteer. You got it? There you go. And here you go. Now, Dennis is now very comfortable for the entire beginning of Act Two until he has to do singing. The care and feeding of your Audrey plant. This is by far the most important that you're going to need to know about. Now, when Mushnik is ready to be eaten, the puppeteer is going to stand up off of the stool, lower himself down until he's very comfortably bent over and the jaw is almost touching. The jaw is touching the ground and the upper part is almost touching the ground. Mushnik goes up towards the plant and knocks three times. Bump, bump, bump. Very slowly, the plant raises up. This is the first time the audience has seen the entire Audrey II open mouth of the shark-like plant we have here. You notice the red curtains are covering up Dennis's legs so that the puppeteer cannot be seen. Now, let me show you what your actors should do whenever they are eaten. You want to be sure as an actor that you don't keep your head directly up so that when it comes down, it hits your head right on the top. This is not good for you. You want to make sure that you're bending your head down, looking at the tongue, so that when he comes down like this, you do the rest. Now, hold on a minute, Audrey. Your actor is going to fall flat down like this, and he'll see the opening here to crawl through. Now, the puppeteer will be slamming the upper part up and down so it looks like he's being eaten. So they'll never see Mushnik actually spread the curtain aside and crawl between Dennis's legs. Just like this. Okay? Once the actor has been eaten and is on the other side, the puppeteer grabs the PVC pipe and they do the laughter. And that should end the scene. I'm now going to do the entire scene as if I'm Mushnik and going to be eaten. It's very important to remember that when the actor is going to be digested, that he lies flat on the bottom of the actual mouth and pulls himself out of the mouth. He can kick his feet if he'd like to. This will add a little more realism, but be sure that you lie flat for your own safety. Here we are. I'm going to knock on the plant. Bump, bump, bump. The plant opens up very slowly. So this is it? This is the plant? Seymour tells him, please, step inside. The money's hidden inside. Are you sure? And he goes, okay, very well. And boom. Well, now that you've seen how to feed your Audrey II, we'd like to talk about a few more tips about making this plant more believable. Whenever the plant is lying on the floor, which is just prior to eating people usually, the puppeteer is bent over and should be in this position, like I am right here. If he takes his head and hits it up, you will give a pulse to the plant. And oftentimes, this looks like it's either digesting or like it's breathing. It gives it an eerie quality. So this is something you might want to explore with your puppeteers. Okay. Now that the plant has shown you how it eats Mushnik, it is also requested that we show you how it eats the other two characters as well. Because in each scene, a different requirement is asked of the puppeteer. In order to make the scene where Audrey gets swallowed by the plant more believable, we ask that you use the song as a way of making a transition from her feeding the plant the water to her actually ending up inside the plant's jaw. Now, if the plant is singing off to the side and Audrey steps over with her watering can and goes to put the watering can into the plant, what the puppeteer can do is swing back and catch her mid-drift and close down on her. See, like I'm doing in slow motion? And then she can fall into the plant like this. And the plant can then do its munching routine. I'm now going to show you that in motion. We give our puppeteer the mouth. This is how it looks in real time. She goes over, puts the watering can into the mouth. He swings into her. She falls in and controls the fall down, where the plant is then chomping on her. Now, while he is chomping on Audrey, Seymour can run in, grab the mouth, and lift it up, and do the old muscle man holding the world up approach, where he's trying to get her out the side. Once she's out of the side of the plant, he jumps out of the way and it closes, just like a fly trap. And then it stays this way the entire rest of the scene until Audrey has said that she wants to be fed to the plant. Then, just like a wedding chapel, it very slowly opens its mouth. Seymour places Audrey into the plant. The plant slowly closes and it masticates from side to side. It does very small chews. It's almost very gentle as it's eating her and the lights come down. It's a very effective scene. Now, in the case of Seymour being eaten, he's fighting with the plant. The plant is going from side to side, shouting obscenities at him, arguing with him back and forth, and Seymour is throwing things into the jaw. Now, he may throw in a can or he may throw in something. The plant can then throw it out. Now, when Seymour is ready to be eaten, he says the line, I believe it is, I'll get you from inside or something like that. He gives the plant a verbal cue that he's going to attack. When that happens, Dennis is going to drop the lower jaw completely. Seymour is going to run at the plant, dive into the bottom of the plant, and Seymour gets swallowed as the plant just keeps on eating him and eating him and eating him. We're now going to show you how that looks, or should look. Now, by Dennis throwing the jaw down just before Seymour is eaten, it covers up the handles with the tongue in a nice way as he dives in. So this is kind of what it looks like. Well, if I can't defeat you, I'll get you in there. Here I come. Ah, 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 ah.
It's time for my 2 cents now, and as you can see, this thing is hot. Couple of things. Number one, there is a fan inside, and there is a pocket to put it on the inside of the palate. So turn that fan in, and the same thing as plant number three. Make sure that you're nice and cool. Number two, for you stage hands, please move the plant by holding and supporting the bottom. Please try not to move it by the thorns here or the leaves, because they will tear and pull off. When you're done with the performances, it's advisable to kind of turn this plant on its side so it's open as much as you can. This is the same for plant number three as well. Open up the plant and run some cool air fans in there as much as possible. When your performance is ended and it takes about an hour to close up, run a fan inside and dry some of that sweat and moisture out of the plants. Likewise, just before you start performances, do the same thing again. You want to try to dry off all the moisture inside, because the more moisture that's trapped inside the costume, the heavier it's going to be. And you want to protect your puppeteer. And again, I say to the lighting crew there, please light this thing from the side. Treat the plant as an actor with makeup. You'll get better results, and you also won't cook your puppeteer. And that is my 2 cents.
Now let's talk about accessories for your Audrey II plant. You will notice that inside of your plant container, you will find 5 large vines. You may use these any way that you wish. They were originally designed to be attached to the fur which is surrounding your Audrey IV plant here. You will notice as you feel along the base of the fur, you will find some grommets, and you will also notice some grommets here. Now you can connect those together like this, and henceforth you can have 5 large vines coming off of your plant. However, if you do this, you must take into consideration, are you going to have the plant move at the end? Is the plant going to walk down towards the audience? If that is the case, you do not want to tie these vines around his feet. Instead, you might consider doing this lovely thing. Take your walls and throw these wonderful things over your walls during intermission and use them as decoration so that when Act 2 begins, it looks like the plant has crawled all over your set. You may use them any way that you wish. There are 5 of them located inside your plant box. And that's how you accessorize your Audrey II plant number 4. All right, now that we've showed you how to accessorize your plant, how to feed your plant, and how to work all 4 of the Audrey plants, we're now going to talk about the final element in the show. And that's when Seymour and Audrey and the dentist and Mushnik are turned into blooming idiots, as we call them, and they grow out of the plant. Now there's two ways to do this. We have included in your set of Audrey plants these wonderful large arms. This is a giant vine, and attached to the vine you will find two flower petals. Coming from the vine is this wonderful green material which covers up your actors when they're actually wearing these masks. Now, you can approach them becoming flowers in two different ways. In some productions, just before they're ready to sing the final song, they will have the actors come from the two sides of the stage, already wearing these arms, walk behind the plant, and then they will join the plants together with these grommets, arm to arm, behind the plant. By hiding it behind the plant, it looks like it's coming out of the actual Audrey II plant. That's one way to do this. Another way that they do this is in the middle of Act II, they will bring in, during one of the scenes, if they have the luxury of being able to do this, they will lay out the arms as they are over here, hiding the flowers, hiding the actual green material, and making it look like this is just another big vine coming from the plant. In this particular case, during blackout, the actors who are doing the arms will, just before the song, walk in and lift up the actual costume and put it on. Now, if I could have a volunteer from the audience. Here, volunteer. Yeah. This is Daryl, and he's going to place the blooming flowers onto his head. Now, notice that when the actor gets into the actual costume, he puts the flower blooms around his head like this and rests the back of his head against this vine part here. On either side of the actual plants, you will find these wooden rods. Now, you notice if he grabs the pole in his hand, he can move it and get the hand to move in a threatening gesture off to the side. This adds a little bit more realism to your blooms and makes them look more threatening. Now, if Daryl can walk over here and face Dennis, now you face, you can see Daryl from the back here. Notice how the arm is situated behind his head, and notice how he's using his arm to move the rod. And that is exactly how they should work this particular plant. I will note that in some cases, our plants don't have this rod here. Instead, there's a strap going across the top of the hand. In this case, the person doing the end flower takes their hand, puts it underneath the strap, and then they use their arm as the actual creature's arm. It's another way of getting more action from our blooming idiots. Okay, guys, turn back around. Smile for them. And now, a Dennis Lancaster subliminal postscript. As these plants were created, there are certain images that were inserted into all the different forms of the plant. We're not going to go into all of them, but if you look at the plants in performance and go, oh my God, that looks like, it probably is. And this is one of them right here. If you look at the blooms of the actual plant, you will notice that some of them go down on their top blooms. The flower petals go down, while some of them go up. This is what we call donkeys and devils. The devils are going to be Mushnik and the dentist. So subliminally, you'll see these horns like objects above their heads, while the donkeys, sort of sad sacks, are Audrey and Seymour, and they're located in these particular ones.
Pretty clever, huh?
Just a little bit of subliminal fun. See if you can find all the others. There you have it. We've tried to answer as many questions as possible about how to work our Audrey II plants. There are probably many more questions that you have. If you find anything in performance that you really like, call us and tell us about it so that we can share it with others. And if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to call us and ask us whatever it is you'd like to know. Dennis, anything to add?
Yes, it's truly a performance piece. This plant allows you a lot of flexibility that other plants do not have, but also the actors that work around the plants you're also part of the process of making this plant believable. So work with your actor, do your blocking, and you'll find this is going to be a fantastic opportunity to really wow your audience.
Also, on a neat note,
you may want to lay out the sheets so that you can put your plants on top of them so they're not sitting on just a bare floor. That works out really super.
And it'll help keep them clean and make them nice and shiny for the next group that uses our Audrey II performance plants. Thank you very much. Have fun.
Knock it.